Alright, we haven't got much left to go. These last two levels are... I guess you could classify them as gauntlet levels.
I suppose.
Oh, because, okay, the special mission in this one is to get Nago here to the very end. Now, you don't find Nago in this...
Shiro.
Hmm, what, sorry, what?
To meet with Shiro.
Yeah, yeah, whatever. Female cat.
Yes.
You don't get Nago in this level, so you have to get him from somewhere else and then come in with him. It's the only level in the game that does that, to be fair.
I know, but that's still kinda stupid, like,
you can just go... Yeah, you can just go back to the first level, pick him up, and then come back out again.
I know. It's not like a big issue or anything, it just seems kinda weird.
I think it's to make sure you go for
if
the
If you played Kirby 64, you'll be used to it.
Yeah. There are a couple shards you gotta get, like, abilities from other levels, and it's kind of annoying, but whatever. It's not like it's a big deal regardless.
Yeah.
This whole level actually just kind of consists of a whole bunch of rooms with different enemies in them. Really, it's not that difficult.
Ignore everything.
Yeah, you can just kind of jump past everything. Also,
they're also angry at you.
They try to throw temptation at you.
They try to trick you.
Stop.
Why would you be tempted not to use this fucking cat? Look at him.
I know.
I use the bird. Green light. I would just use the bird.
Red light. Green light.
Squish.
I like how he squishes down with Kirby.
Yeah.
Oh, these guys just want
to
be.
The only way to get the fire out.
Yeah. I picked the fire ability with Nago because it's probably just the best ability for this shit. It clears out enemies super fast.
Yeah, it is long range too, so...
Yeah. The only thing it's not really good for is bosses, because it seems to do minimal damage. But look at that shit.
That's pretty good.
Oh, what a challenge.
What? But again,
just stumbling.
Then again, you've, like, been mostly avoiding the enemy so far.
Yeah. Again, it's... Ow. This level really isn't that hard. It's just...
I question how the gravity of this fire works sometimes, but...
Oh, fuck it.
I don't know.
I couldn't tell you. Sorry, guys.
It looks so sad!
Who looks so sad? Who looks like he wants to fucking kill himself?
Or just killed, like, the cat, because...
I'm good enough for Kirby.
Spiders, fuck off.
Oh, no, spiders.
They can't even touch you, what the fuck?
I don't know.
Oh, no, fish!
Oh, no, fake- Ah!
Oh. Go away, sir.
I don't need to see you ever again.
Oh, no.
What? Now what?
Those things.
They look confused.
What's going on, old dad?
Hi, fake Kirby.
Ooh, that you're
I still don't understand the fake Kirby.
I don't get it. Bye, guys.
God damn it!
Levels did a really poor attempt.
It's like, god damn it, Levels, stop fucking trying to guilt trip me.
You're a terrible person.
Look at all these sad animals.
It's your final trial.
Abandon your friends.
You have to go full renegade to get the good ending.
Gotta punch Nago out of a window.
Oh my god. Ow. Really? The drawings on the wall that come to life as real enemies. I don't know why they're not just real enemies in the first place.
Because... It looks cool, shut up.
Sorry. Gosh. These guys can kind of be annoying just because they like to all jump up at the same time. Like assholes. I suppose if I was a bit more patient, I wouldn't care, but whatever.
Oh, they give you health, so...
Yeah.
Like, whatever.
Can get back to... Well, almost...
That'd be an awful life being inside the wall like that.
Look, they're happy with their lifestyle, okay?
I don't know why, but they are.
Just because you don't understand what it's like to be a hermit. A wall hermit.
A wall hermit. Yeah. Quite frankly, I don't think I want to
here every day.
Quite frankly, I don't think I really want to understand.
I think that's the end of the level. Yep, there we go, see? Easy shit!
Yay!
True love. It's all worth it. Look how happy they are.
Exactly. Let's get the fuck out of here. The
cutest couple.
Anyway, last level's coming up next, and it's just a mini boss rush, essentially.
Basically.
You do get a nice new piece of music for it, though.
Oh yeah,
Jesus.
I dig this.
I heard this track a long time before I even knew what this game was, and I can't remember where.
I didn't know about it until I played the game.
Yeah, same.
Anyway, I would suggest completely ignoring the animal helpers for this level. Unless you think it makes it easier. In which case, fucking go for it, I guess.
I don't know. Like, the animal buddies for like, going through the levels, they're good. But, like, whenever you're fighting a boss, I prefer just going as Kirby.
Yeah. Ow. Basically, the...
At first,
sorry, I'm gonna go first.
I was just gonna say, at first I didn't even know this was a boss rush.
Yeah, no, it is though. All you have to do to get the heart star in this level is basically every boss you beat, every time a new ability is presented to you, suck it up. That's it, basically. Like here.
I think there's a level like that for like every Kirby game that has those kinds of collectibles.
Yeah.
So are we getting like feathers?
We're getting feathers, we're collecting angel wings.
Oh, okay.
There's an angel at the end of the level, and you need to get her wings back. I don't know why they're spread throughout the tower, but I mean, whatever. Details.
Once you do, she transforms into 0-2.
Stop.
Stop Can't it!
Haven't e- ah, fuck off. Haven't even met 0-1 yet, come on.
Half a health bar left, will fuck them. You.
Yeah, so it's so straightforward, I can't even talk about it anymore. It's just get ability from mini boss, break block.
Break blocks.
You get you feather. Win. Woo.
Ah, yes, the one true geeks of the snowman.
A fucking
parasol.
Umbrella.
You just sort of wave the parasol at the snow and it works.
Well, yeah. I mean, you're hitting it with things. Doesn't matter what it's made of. It's gonna fucking die. It's not like snow is the most like sturdy, bit like material.
It's the sturdy thing.
It's just
pretty sure you could just blow at it and it'll fade away.
It's just frozen water that isn't frozen yet.
Ah yes, Kirby's greatest adversaries: a giant fucking broom.
Giant broom. Please die. Please die.
Paint expression.
Paint
expression. Oh, okay,
what?
Nice!
Wait,
nice!
What?
I don't know.
What happened there?
Whatever.
I absorb your attacks.
Oh, go down. Go down, Kirby. Go now, we're actually gonna leave that.
What?
Why?
Because I want to show off a bad ending first.
Yeah.
So,
Oh. We're
leaving
okay.
One angel feather. Because if you don't get 100%, you don't get the good ending.
I assume you save stated there?
No.
So you just did the level over again after you showed off the bad ending?
Yeah. Don't worry, all right. I don't show the entire level off. Like, that'd be kind of boring, among other things.
Yeah.
I think we could shit for this fucking mini-boss rush twice.
It's hard enough to get once.
Yeah. I mean, it's a fine enough level to go through, but it's not exactly like, oh shit, look at all the things I can talk about. We're fighting a mini-boss.
Alright, guys, I really want to talk about these mini-bosses.
Yeah, this isn't exactly exciting.
It's okay, we're pretty much done here. I think that was the last one, actually. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. I was pretty sure you went for, like, all the abilities anyway, so...
Yeah. Sad Angel.
Don't worry. Kirby
Bye.
Doesn't give...
We'll come See back ya. For you.
Well, yeah. I mean, you didn't need a max tomato, but it's still nice.
Yeah. No, no, tiny
Look at his face! Look at his face!
You okay there, buddy?
You okay there, DDD?
I think DDD's alright, guys. Yeah,
It's another standard DDD fight. Actually, his AI works a bit differently here. If you know how to abuse it, it's incredibly easy.
But it's basically the same as the DDD fights in, like, all the other Dreamland games.
Pretty much. Although, there is a little something coming at the, like, later on, when I deplete his health bar. I would like to say this is probably one of my favorite renditions of the theme.
Oh yeah, it's surprisingly really good.
If we can just get him to... There we go. Oh, you're dead now! Oh.
Wait, what?
Dedede, buddy!
You okay, Dedede?
Are you fucking alright? Oh dear!
Dedede, what's going on with you?
I don't think he's okay.
Dedede, you just turned into fucking Pac-Man, like what?
Fairly traumatic experiences aside, he only really has two attacks and that's it.
He makes the same sound effect.
He makes the same sound effect as Pac-Man too, you're right. God fucking.
The only way you can damage him, however, is if he chooses to shoot. Which can sometimes be very annoying if he decides to keep going for the chomping attack over and over and over and over and over and over and over again.
God damn it, DDD, we're not fucking... We're not playing fucking Pac-Man.
Look, it's not his fault, okay?
No, that's what he's possessed. Again.
Again. He really needs to...
Why must he always go after something? Why always DDD? Why not the one who has the sword and stuff?
Not Meta Knight? Who gives a shit about Meta Knight? Where is Meta Knight for all this?
Where is Meta Knight?
You're not even here! Fucking Dreamland's been taken over by this demonic fucking, like, thing that possesses everyone, and Meta Knight's like, it's not worth my time. I'm just gonna go over here and be edgy.
No, it's like Meta Knight was planning to help out, but he was taking too long trying to look cool.
How do I enter right? Anyway, that's the game beat, and we're done.
Yay, we beat the game! See, it's all happy now. We beat the game.
And there's fucking Gooey. Hi Gooey.
Gooey. I mean, this is essentially just the bad ending. You beat the Eevee, and then the game just ends.
That was very fine.
Yeah, I think it does a very good job in making you feel incredibly unsatisfied.
You just get the scene like, okay, there is something with these fucking
It's not even you get this feeling. Wait till the end of the credits, and you'll see.
Okay. I've actually never seen the bad ending, so...
It's just this. We have about... How many minutes is this going for? Okay, we have
2 minutes left?
We have 2 minutes! would you like to look over the enemy names?
Popon!
Bro, Flipper, Kappa.
Kappa? Oh, Kappar. I thought that was Kappa. Kappa.
Bobbin,
Cammy, Squishy.
Kappa actually kind of looks like a Pokemon, I know.
The shark is called Joel!
Sharky Joe!
It's just called Joel.
Kappa.
I don't know if these are these translated right, because I don't remember any of these names.
Maku.
I wouldn't be too surprised if they weren't. Like, if it was just, like, a really direct translation of him.
Then again, actually...
Loud! It's just a cloud without a C!
The cloud is literally named Loud. Fuck you.
Chili!
Chili! Okay, if I could say something, though. This enemy roll call does at least point out there are a lot of enemies in this game that are just unique to this game alone.
Yeah.
I don't think that's something we talked about, actually, because, well, I mean, like, apart from the fate.
It's not something you directly notice, so... But, yeah, the Faker called Badamon is cool. Anyway, yeah, it's cool that it has its own unique enemies, even if, you know, most of them don't really do all, like, a whole lot.
They're all mostly the same.
Yeah. Including his jump. Except there's a giant broom, of course.
Jumper shoot!
That's its name!
Jumper shoot!
Jumper shoot, man.
Yuki!
Gooey,
Blocky!
You're such a special creature.
Gooey never appears after this, right?
And...
Never again.
I do like this credit theme, though. Also... Hey, buddy!
And... Dark. Hey! That's not obvious!
Hi, buddy!
Hi, buddy!
Game over. Game over!
Well,
I'm pretty satisfied with this playthrough.
Anyway, we'll see you next part for the real ending.
Oh, good. I'm starting to feel gyps. Bye.
Bye!
Oh, God. Okay, yeah, bye.